Welcome to CertBlaster. In this session, we'll look at some of the performance-based question types that address exam sub-objective 1.9 on the A+2-2901 test. In the CertBlaster interface, we'll choose A+2-2901 exam 1. Because I need full information for the presentation, I'm picking study mode, and I won't use the timer since we don't need it for this exercise. Here I want to talk about exam sub-objective 1.9 and a performance-based question, so I'll skip the first two performance-based to this one. It's very important that you know 1.9 by heart, as you'll soon see. The scenario that sub-objective 1.9 puts you in is one where you are asked to perform a custom PC configuration based on customer specifications or needs. In the question, it's a CAD/CAM workstation. Taking a closer look, here's the question. You're assembling a CAD/CAM design workstation from parts available. Choose those that meet the requirements. Drag the labels to the correct motherboard location. Examine the left pane, and you'll see there's a list of components. On the right is the motherboard with highlighted locations. These are the targets. I'll display a portion of 1.9 that includes the CAD/CAM design workstation requirements. You'll need to know this inside out by the time you go up for the test. If you do this right, you'll make sub-objective 1.9 your virtual answer grid. Under this objective, CompTIA's requirement for a CAD/CAM design workstation is a multi-core processor, high-end video, and maximum RAM. With that in mind, check your choices. The first choice is 8 gigabytes of RAM, a decent amount, but not the only one. Checking the rest of the choices shows that 32 gigabytes is available, and since the requirement is maximum RAM, the choice is simple. I'll drag the 32 gigabytes of memory to the memory slots on the motherboard. Next from the top is a processor choice, the AMD 145 Sempron. This is a decent processor, but only a single-core model. We need a multi-core, and the AMD FX8150 has 8 cores, which easily qualifies as multi-core. That label goes to the processor. Here's where you realize the knowledge of the actual hardware specifications are as important as the exam objective requirements. Finally, only the video choice remains. It is between the GeForce GTX 760 with 4 gigabytes of memory and the NVIDIA GeForce GT240 that has 1 gigabyte of memory. GTX outperforms the GT and has more and faster memory, so it satisfies CompTIA's high-end video requirement. I'll drag the Galaxy GeForce card to the slot, and since we're in study mode, we can check the answer. Success! We get a question answered correctly. As you can see, there's a detailed explanation of what we did and why we did it, if anything is unclear. Use the process of elimination combined with your hardware knowledge to master any of the questions that address sub-objective 1.9. Good luck! And be sure to check out the other resources available at CertBlaster.com.